paradigm shift.
An educational comedy.
It's not a cause. Not a movement.
It's not a social group you can slap a label on to.
It's an idea. It's an intention.
It's an intuition.
A mindset in which reality can be explored.
A genuine expression.
Discernment.
Critical thinking and imagination.
To look inward upon ourselves.
To better understand the external world around us.
And yes,
few egos are bound to be bruised.
With our silly, strange, politically incorrect.
Your
style
of going about things.
Real and raw honesty.
Which invites you to be
you to the fullest.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to yet another episode of Paradigm Shift, an educational comedy. And we are here with Thinking Kristen and the RPM Kid. And just take the RPM Kid and add a .deviantart.com. And just take Thinking Kristen and add a .deviantart.com. And there you go. And this is by no means Kristen's first hangout. But as far as I know, this is the RPM Kid's first hangout. And we're here to discuss art and social anxiety.
Yep. It was funny putting the link into the air. It was funny because Google was like, you have to install this plugin into Firefox, and Firefox did not want me to install that plugin. So that was a fun run around, just trying to get everything to work. Had to jump into Firefox Developer Edition and see if that worked, and it did. I know there is a way of doing it with Firefox, but mine just didn't want to work.
Weird. Are you on Windows or Mac?
Windows 10.
I'm on Linux, and so is Kristen.
I have
my cell phone.
Oh, well, you're on your cell phone now, but your laptop's got Linux on it.
Yeah.
Is your cell phone an Android or is it a Apple?
Android.
Okay, then it's using a Linux kernel. So technically it is Linux.
Also,
I'm a nerd.
Back, that little cube you see stuff in the corner on top of that giant box right there is the computer I've built. The USB 3.0 header pin is bent, so that's why I can't use it, which I wish I could.
Ah, fun with a capital F-U.
Yes. Extreme. Make the capital F-U just make it huge. I don't care.
Like Empire State Building capital F-U.
Exactly.
So, would you feel more comfortable with you starting on a rant about social anxiety, or would you rather have Kristen start first because she's just like a veteran social anxiety ranter? This is nothing new for her. And then you could chime in after that. Which way would you...
I'll go after Kristen.
Okay. We'll let Kristen set the tone. So I will mute and shut up and let her start.
Okay. It's probably a good idea that we're getting this out of the way now, because I've also realized, though, that the thing I talk the most coherently about is how incoherent I am. So
irony sandwich.
Yep. Exactly. I'm basically just really, really weird. And, you know, I have a lot of strange interests, nerdy interests and stuff, and my friends say that it's the cute kind of nerdy, but, you know, that's all just opinion. I personally think that I'm just, like, too weird to live, too rare to die type person. And I've realized that the best friends that I have are the friends that have been able to accept how awkward I am around people. Which my friend, they always say, like, they don't think I'm that awkward.
And we accept that she beats up on herself a lot and very unnecessarily.
That's me too.
Yeah. I know I'm a little bit extreme with it sometimes, but honestly, I wish I was more of the kind of person who was really charismatic and charming, and so, and I know I am sometimes, and it's all...
A little bit with a little asterisk next to it to indicate that it means, like, the polar opposite of a little bit.
Not really. I mean...
You get pretty extreme sometimes. She does what I refer to as raising the bar. Like, she'll be like, oh, well, I can't feel deserving and worthy and this and that unless this, 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 and this happens. Then this, 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 and this ends up happening. And then she's like, well, that doesn't count. Because if that counted, then this, 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 this would happen. So she raises the bar. Then this, 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 this happens. She's like, well, that doesn't count either. Because, and eventually she gets the bar raised so high that all even she is forced to laugh at it. Because it just gets into these levels of, like, improbable ridiculousness that, you know, even she knows that it sounds like, you know, unicorns, fairies, and whatever. Like, you know, it just gets extreme ridiculous. It's what I call the perfectionist syndrome. With perfectionism, it means nothing is ever good enough. So no matter how good you do, it's never good enough.
That's me. That's 100% me.
Yeah. But the thing is that's a total, like, total setup to be indefinitely miserable. Because if nothing is ever good enough, that's not really, you know, like, most people think that perfectionism is, you know, overly obsessive on trying to get things perfect, but what it actually is making sure that you never get anything right, much less perfect, because no matter how right it is, it's still not right enough, no matter what. You could develop the cure for cancer, and it's like, well, it's not good enough, because if it's good enough, I'd have developed a cure for cancer and diabetes, you know, always raising the fucking bar.
Yeah, and I've noticed that a big part of me has, I have a lot of people who actually do like me, and since I'm so afraid to make a bad impression, I could have probably had a lot more friendships with people and deeper friendships with people, but I don't let it get to that level, usually. I like to stay in my own little cave away from people because there's a lot of risk that comes with being yourself in front of them, and that risk doesn't necessarily mean that it could end up, you know, failing or anything. But
the biggest risk is getting exactly what you want, because comfort zone doesn't mean it feels nice. Comfort zone means you're comfortable with it, meaning you're used to it. It's the same old, same old. You're familiar with it. You know how to navigate it. So if shit and crap and misery and suffering and depression and all that is your comfort zone, that's the same old, what you're used to, and, you know, you have a fear of change and a fear of that which is different from your comfort zone, then everything you want is antithetical to your current comfort zone, so actually getting what you want scares the shit out of you more than actual failure. And that's where self-sabotage comes in. And that's incredibly common today.
Well, since I've been making more friends, because now that I'm really, over like the past year, I've been realizing just how all the things that I've been telling myself have been excuses to keep myself from putting myself out there or just being okay with myself. So regardless of feeling uncomfortable, I've been putting myself into different social settings and other things, meeting groups of people outside the people I already know, and I've actually been doing pretty good. I mean, the whole time I'm just like questioning every little thing I do, but I've been making new friends, and I've noticed that I've been making new friends. I mean, regardless of what kind of friendships they aren't necessarily super close. They do like me for me. So, and I know that myself personally, I really like people who are awkward or, you know, just weird and different. And so, I guess when I think of it that way, it makes sense that someone else could like that too. Could like someone just altogether an individual and varying levels of just, my friends have been able to accept that in me, so I wish I was someone who was confident all the time.
Your signal's breaking up a little bit, Kristen.
Like, you know, at least not right away.
Your video was frozen and your words were like doing like the whole Max Headroom thing.
I'll turn off. Okay. Is this any better?
Oh yeah, it sounds much better.
So far, so good.
Okay. I don't know how much you guys actually were able to get out of that.
We heard the vast majority of it, so more than enough came through for you to accurately make your points. I was just letting you know that there was some distortion involved.
All right. And like right now, whenever I'm talking to my friends, sometimes, you know, when you're actually talking voice to voice, there's a lot of opportunity for misspeaking, and a lot of times it's just jumbling words or mixing them up or something.
Excuse me yawning so much. It's not an indication of boredom. I just didn't get much sleep last night.
Okay. Yeah, so when I hear my friends misspeak, I don't judge them for it at all, but when I misspeak, like, I know I overreact about it.
I do that all the time, too. It's like, I'll be talking, and then I'll slip up in something. I'm just like, that's not entirely what I wanted to say, but...
Praying that people get your meaning and don't think that you're, like, completely incoherent.
Well, one thing that I've learned is that no matter what you say or do, no matter how you say it or how you do it, there's always going to be some people that are just going to think it's horrible and not like it no matter what. Especially those people that are just not happy unless they're just not happy. And then there's always going to be people who do like it, you know, and you know, do accept it and whatever else. So there's no way that you can appease everybody. To quote Winston Churchill, love isn't appeasement is. And the even weirder thing is when we're trying to appease others, we're not even trying to appease others. What we're actually trying to appease is our own psychological projection that we've actually placed over others. Because we can't actually know what they expect of us or not, because we're not mind readers and we can't just kind of tap in and do the telepathy thing. So we're just making all these assumptions about what we think they expect of us or not. So, you know, when we have these illusions of, oh my God, I said the wrong thing or I failed or whatever, usually it's when they're not reacting adversely to anything at all. they're just, you know, continuing, like, okay, you know, everything's cool. There's no apparent, you know, reaction from them. They're not like, hey, what the fuck? But we're sitting here thinking, like, oh, my God, I said that wrong. I did that wrong. I da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Because we think we're trying to appease them, but really we're trying to appease a psychological projection that we have put over them. And we don't even realize that that's actually what we're trying to appease.
Yes. It's not fair for me to assume that other people are completely not okay with someone who's weird. I mean, or someone... And it's not fair for me to assume that they would even think I'm weird the same way that I do about myself. And also, after a while of thinking about the word weird, that...
By the way, Katarina messaged me. She's not going to be able to make it because apparently she's currently doing something in person physically with another friend at the moment or something. And it's kind of going longer than she thought it would. So, you know, it's something that came up. So Katarina is not going to be able to make it. I don't know if Rich will be able to make it. He hasn't responded back to me yet, so.
Okay.
That's really interesting.
It's the small band of people this time instead of everyone.
Yeah.
Yep. That's fine. There will always be opportunities in the future for more people. These things just, you know, they go how they go. And then there's this one guy in Poland who may or may not show up, depending.
Oh, yeah, Poland. The Eastern European countries, you know. Them.
Ah, Bogdan.
Sorry, I'm Ukrainian. My grandparents are from Ukraine, so I had to make a somewhat Eastern European jokey accent.
That's great.
Cześć, jak się masz? Bardzo dobrze. Ah, polski bardzo.
Oh, I can't remember the song right now, but there's a Ukrainian folk song that sounds very upbeat and. When you look at the direct translation, it's about a guy getting drunk and beating his wife and kids.
Oh, that's funny.
Ukraine.
Damn it!
Sounds so happy and wonderful until you get the translation. Then you're like, what?
Oh.
Hey, that is happy and wonderful to those Ukrainians.
It's just like. I was...
It's like Ukrainian version of Smack My Bitch Up.
Yes. Only in a slightly way less understandable manner. Slightly way less understandable. That word choice was great.
I got drunk. I take the broom. That before I was raping my horse. Then I take the sheet-covered broom, and I smack the fuck out of my wife, and I drink another drink, and I hit her with the broom, and I rape the horse a little more. I hit the X on the cows that kick, and that's how we do safe sex in the old Ukraine. No.
That's very like that.
I don't know if that was pre-rehearsed or not, but it sounded like it.
You know, just right? The total improv of just, like, just letting it all just fly out of my ass. Total improv.
I How didn't could know I, you could speak out of your I, ass, but okay.
I couldn't have rehearsed that without also having a time machine or a crystal ball that worked. Because this is just, like, conversation in the moment. I would have had to have known that you were going to mention the fucked up Ukrainian drinking song in order for that to have been rehearsed.
Yeah, I was just like, he's gonna know that I'm going, he's gonna like the fact that I know or reference a old Ukrainian drinking song about beating your wife and kids and then the kids run. I think the kids run away at the end of it, but I'm not entirely sure.
Then the kids run to America, And they get the American guns, and they go back to their dad and say, fuck you, you beat me and mom too much, now you die.
Accurate. Fairly accurate. You pick up a wallet, they'll tell the police that you stole their wallet. Welcome to Cave.
One thing that I was going to say earlier is that, like, you know, some people aren't going to like you no matter what, but, like, what right do we actually have to tell them that they can't if you really think about it? Like, I think we all feel that if we want to dislike someone that, you know, we have the right to do that, right? So if someone dislikes us, you know, who are we to stand there and say, oh, you have to like us, otherwise you're a rude, fucking, bad, horrible person, shit-face, whatever. When, if someone said that to us because we didn't like somebody, we'd be like, well, wait a minute, what the fuck? Who are you to tell me, you know, what I can and can't feel? What, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, I mean, when we look at it like that, not only do we not have the right to tell someone else that they can't like us, why would you want someone who you think has a shitty personality anyway to like you anyway? That's like, oh, the flies don't approve of me, so I have to roll in dog shit to try to appease them. It doesn't really make much sense, does it?
No. Especially the rolling and dog shit part, that would just be disgusting.
Well, we do the metaphoric equivalent of that.
That's true. You'll find me highly sarcastic and very literal person. Highly sarcastic and highly literal. And I'm looking at my own video feed, and it looks like my eyes are about to fall out of my head.
Whereas I am not sarcastic at all, ever. Especially while I'm saying that.
I was about to say, I'm like, is that irony, or is that sarcasm, or is that sarcastic irony, or is that ironically sarcastic? I don't know.
So maybe hitting you with an iron made of sarcasm. Or hitting someone's wife with an iron made of sarcasm. I don't know.
Only in Ukraine does that happen. And maybe Russia. Probably Russia, too. Not Poland.
Most common elements in universe. Hydrogen, carbon, and irony.
And plutonium. You cannot... Or stellium. You cannot forget stellium.
Ah, yes. Well, Putin is very metaphysical because he understands that you are going to get out what you put in.
Oh, the echo. I heard the echo in my own room. That echo will... That's going to be fun to watch on the video.
Yeah, so honestly, it's like... If you're not willing to be your authentic self, and you're going to get all these miserable consequences for living a lie. But if you are your authentic self, some people will still hate you, but then there will be the others who accept you. Then why not just be yourself? Fuck the haters, let them think what they want, that's fine, that's their right. And appreciate the people who actually like you. Why, you know, get all hot and bothered because so-and-so doesn't like you or whatever. And especially, like, when it comes to cliques in high school and everything, it's like, the most popular cliques are usually the ones that have the highest population of assholes. So it's like, okay, so they're more popular, but so what? They're a bunch of dicks. What's so desirable about that? I mean, if getting right. raped in the ass with a 12-inch cock was popular, would you want to have that done to you just because it's popular?
No. All of the no's.
How about the quote from the 2010 Alice in Wonderland movie where Alice said, if the majority of people thought that wearing a codfish on your head was proper, would you wear one?
I love that. I love that movie.
It's like, who gives a shit what the fucking majority thinks? The majority is a bunch of frickin' brainwashed, dysfunctional, you know, pathological people anyway, that are just doing what, you know, the mainstream media tells them to do, and what fads and trends tell them to do, and what their peers tell them to do, and it's, you know, it's like, why participate in that? Isn't it kind of better to be the outcast? But of course, let's not be different like everyone else, because then that's just following yet another trend, yet another meme. Because when all these people are like, oh, I'm going to be different. Yeah, I'm different. They're being different like everyone else. And then there's like this whole like definition of what being different is. And then everybody starts to like meme that. So then it becomes like its own aspect of conformity.
I find a lot of irony when people say I want to be different. It's just like, but then, and then everyone else starts doing it. It's like, but then you're glomming on to the same idea. It's like, you're being different by all being the same, and that's really, it's funny, it's sad, and it's ironic.
Yeah, it's like, how about just be yourself, because you already are that. And if you try to be something other than that, then you're just being a fucking poser. Ta-da.
Or pretentious. I like to use the word pretentious because I despise pretentious people.
Poser.
I think that, same thing, basically. But, and also, this goes into the whole, you know, how hipsters shame people for liking mainstream things. I say, like whatever you like, for whatever, just for the fact that you like it, as, you know, popular or unpopular it may be, and that honestly is the most hipster thing you can do, just to reject all the things that say, okay, I have to like this because...
Yeah, like anything you like.
I can't like this because it's popular. Like, there's, literally, they don't like music because it'll get played on the radio. And I just think myself, but that is just as closed-minded as people who won't play anything outside of the radio. So,
yeah.
The double face palm is strong with this one.
Yeah, it's like what Bashar said about the aspects of the gullible, the skeptical, and the cynical, whereas it's good to have open-minded skepticism, but people who are cynics and gullible are actually two aspects of the same thing. Because cynics say, I believe what I believe, and I'm not willing to, you know, consider anything else, but the gullible people, by accepting everything with no filters whatsoever, are still saying, I'm going to believe what I believe and I'm not accepting anything else. Then the problem comes in to where when someone who is cynical ends up dismissing evidence about something because they have bought into the folk tale that might have been told to them by somebody who was indeed gullible. So it's like, who's the fool? The fool or the fool that follows the fool?
Just goes on in one gigantic circle.
As Obi-Wan Kenobi said, who's the bigger fool? The fool or the fool that follows?
As I cock my head awkwardly and thought, oh,
so that cracked my neck. Yeah, it's all about as doing what Dave usually will.
Yeah, just kind of like how people are like, I hate the mainstream news. It's full of lies, so I'm going to watch the independent news. And, okay, yeah, there's more lies in the mainstream news than independent news. That's true. But the problem is that if you're blindly accepting whatever you're taking in with no critical thinking and no discernment whatsoever, then how is being brainwashed by the independent media any different than being brainwashed by the mainstream media at that point? Because if there's no process of critical thinking and discernment, then you're just like a hypnotized zombie going, I'm going to take in whatever I am told. Ooh. You know what I mean? And GeneralTate just popped in.
Hello.
GeneralTate.deviantart.com.
Hey, Rich.
Hello.
Yep, we're just trying to defeat the social anxiety belief systems by just explaining the, you know, the brainwashing and conformity and the bullshit and, you know, being different like everyone else and, oh, let's go from being brainwashed by the mainstream to being brainwashed by independent and, you know, and who gives a shit what a bunch of assholes think anyway? Why not just be authentic? Why not just be you, whatever that is in the moment? Why conform to a meme or why be different? Like everyone else, and then that ends up becoming its own meme to be conformed to, and
gross.
Still there, Rick?
Mm-hmm. I am.
So what are your thoughts? I know that you and I both see a lot of that sort of thing on Facebook, all these headline readers, and then you get into the dichotomy hamster wheels of two people being on opposite sides, and nobody can see a middle ground. You try to present the middle ground to them, and they just assume that because it's not what they wanted to hear, that you must be playing for the enemy team. So, like, both sides are saying that you're working for the other side. And it's like, well, at least you both can agree on something.
Well, it's kind of funny to me. This isn't really on, you know, conforming, not conforming, but the kind of dichotomies that exist around, you know, because right now I'm currently looking for work because, you know, as most of you know, I got laid off from my job 28th of August. And, you know, it's... I was working down at Millionaire, which is a fixed base operator for aircraft down at the local airport. They said they'd probably get my job back to me in a couple of months, something like that. You know, just keep checking in, whatever. I don't, you know. But anyway, meanwhile, I'm just kind of looking around. But it's kind of funny when you're looking around for work how people are, like, constantly, like, pressuring you, like, you need to find something, you have to do it this way, you have to find some, even if it's some demeanial slave job where you're only making, like, $9 an hour, you know, breaking your back, and, you know, suffering is the only real reality. I mean, it's when there's a complete middle ground where you can just kind of, you know, research, look into things. I mean, how you can make money on YouTube, things of that nature.
Yeah, that's the main problem that I have. Like, you know, people are locked into these belief systems that the only way to do anything is with all this suffering and neurosis and slavery, and they have such a lack of faith in themselves that when I try to tell them things like, you know, making money on YouTube is actually not that hard, you know, to be like a rocket scientist or anything to do it, all the excuses pop up. Well, nothing I do is good enough. Why would people watch me anyway? But nobody's going to like what I have to say anyway. Nobody's going to like what I'm doing. It's never going to be good enough. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Kristen's currently working that one out of her system when it comes to YouTube.
I'm not very organized when I bring up ideas. I don't think
But I already said, just point, shoot, and upload. I mean, you've got all this cool stuff you could do, just you being you. You've got thoughts on things, just record it and put it up there. You're out in nature, you know, take some video, record it, put it up there, monetize it. I mean, you've got, like, stupid, like, 15-second corny-ass cat videos made on, like, an obsolete 10-year-old camera that's grainy and pixelated and looks like dog shit, and the thing's got, like, you know, 57 million views. But, you know, I mean, come on, you know. It's just that you're just fighting your own paradigms right now. No, it can't be easy, it can't be simple. Nobody can like what I have to say, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So then you kind of like lock yourself in that hamster wheel and paralyze yourself, so while you're doing that, what are you not doing? You're not making videos. So then you're not making money from the videos that you're not making and not putting online. So then you can observe how much money you're not making and go, see, that's proof that I can't do it. All. That's what, like what I was saying earlier, people are more afraid of their success than failure because they're used to failure. They're used to suffering. That's the only reality. Failure, suffering, misery. That's real. I'm comfortable with that. I'm used to that. I know how to navigate that. That's my comfort zone. But all this other positive stuff, ooh, that's scary. I can't, ooh. Not my comfort zone. I was never taught how to navigate that.
As for the YouTube thing, Kristen, I'm sorry if I keep mispronouncing your name.
It's Kristen. You've got it right as far as I can tell.
Okay. I'm also trying to do a YouTube, but tech YouTube channel. The only issue with that is money, which is kind of an ironic thing. It's like you're trying to make money off of YouTube, but you have to spend money to get the stuff to review. Until you start getting enough subs, and then companies are just like, here, have a motherboard, here, have a graphics card, here, have whatever the hell you want. Anyway.
And because your belief systems are allowing you to miss one important thing, software reviews are just as important, and there's a lot of really awesome software that's free, and it doesn't cost anything to record your desktop to a video. As a matter of fact, I can enable screen share right now in this chat. So can you. So can Rich, you know. And I don't have to pay for that. That's just a function of Google Hangout. I can enable screen share. There it is. And if I want to demonstrate a piece of software on that screen share, I can most definitely do that. So why do you think that hardware reviews are the only types of videos that you could monetize that people could possibly ever be interested in? How many pieces of software are there out there?
Billions.
Ooh, I just like took your paradigm and went.
The thing is,
you're a geek. You know this already.
Yeah, the thing is, I'm very much more. I'm not very good at speaking English. I know my hardware much better than I know my software. I can list off a bunch of facts about hardware, and I'm much better at diagnosing issues with hardware than I am with software. I have. As I was having before, the issue with Firefox.
Why not diagnose software issues, though? Why not just demonstrate really cool software? Because for every piece of cool software, there's millions and millions of people that don't know about it and have never fucking heard of it until they run into your video and see it and go, wow, that's really cool. And then they share it with their friends. And isn't it lucky for you that that video is monetized? So as they're sharing it, you're making money. And all you did was just open up the software and go, hey, let's poke around in this. Let's see what this does. This is pretty cool. Oh, look at Kaden Live. Look at GIMP. Look at OpenOffice. Look at LibreOffice. Look at Blender. Look at Inkscape. Look at the list goes on and on and on and on and on. Completely free softwares. Tons of them. Shitloads of them.
Definitely Blender.
What about Firefox plugins? There's a lot of cool ones of those you could demonstrate, you know, AdBlock Plus, Ant Downloader, Video Download Helper, Easy YouTube Downloader, so on and so forth. So many of these things. There's so many different videos you can create for all these different softwares and plugins and things. So why does it have to be diagnosing a problem? You see, that's that societal dichotomy. I mean, we're taught to view the world as some sort of equation to be solved when most data out there is observable, not calculatable anyway. It's observable data. Try observing a tree by closing your eyes and calculating tree probabilities about whether or not there's a tree in front of you. No, that's not going to work freaking well. Now, will it? No. So the word equation and problem are used synonymously, so if we think every aspect of life is an equation to be solved, then so we think it's a problem to be solved, that means life is nothing but problems, misery, suffering, problems, that's all that's real. That can be our only focus, there's nothing else. So of course that's why you would think, well, I could only make videos if I'm diagnosing problems. Because, you know, just the idea of opening up software and saying, hey, let's poke around in this, this is cool, doesn't pop up because you're not thinking, you know, there's tons of people who probably never heard of that software that could really benefit from that software. Now they found it through my video. They're going to share my video, and I'm going to make money on that video because it's being shared. See what I mean?
Yeah. I'm just looking at the Google chat, and there's two of the same. GeneralTate is double.
Yeah.
Well, that's here. My browser crashed, and I had to reload the page, and oh. Google hasn't recognized that the first one dropped off, and the second one is in place of that first one. Google can be kind of retarded sometimes.
Google be like, I derped.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
I love it how we were supposed to be talking about anxiety and art, and then we're talking about how Google is just glitching out.
That's how these conversations go. We talk about all sorts of things. Me and Dave have gone from serious issues on racism to talking about how Kissinger's raping Obama in the asshole and whatever else. I mean, that's just kind of what happens, or how, you know, Bill Clinton likes to get on with Monica or whatever we come up with. I don't know.
What is Bill Clinton's opinion on that anyway? Bill, are you here?
No, I think he's kind of out of the studio right now.
No, you're not going to do the Bill Clinton impression today.
Not today.
I kind of sore throat, sucking too much dick.
No, I'm just busy. I've been busy most of the day today.
Same. I had a raging migraine throughout the school day, and
migraines are assholes.
Yeah, they really are.
I didn't get much sleep, but I've been doing a lot of work around the house and stuff today, a lot of cleaning and sorting and organizing, hence why you see back there box of stuff and the stuff next to it and all that. I'm kind of taking a pause in my cleaning mission to, you know, have this hang out.
I just saw the Christmas-y looking lights. I'm like, should I say something? Oh, wait, I just did say something.
efficient lighting. It works. LED.
It works. LEDs. Four of them. As I wave my arms about in completely useful manner.
You obviously have no way of seeing this, but my desk, it's a right-angle glass desk, and I've got it lined with blue glowing LED lights all around the border, and so the light, just because of the way the glass is, it just shines through the glass of the entire desk, so it just looks like the whole desk is freaking just glowing blue. It's pretty cool.
I want your desk. I have this old desk. I don't even know what kind of wood this is. It's probably just... Actually, I'm not even going to say, because I don't wood well.
It's morning.
Well, either.
Morning wood!
Oh, I saw that. I'm just like, I know he's going to reference that at one point or another.
Afternoon wood at the moment, I guess.
Ba-dun-sh.
Yeah. And I have a 27 terabyte file server, but, you know, haters gonna hate.
I have an Acer XB270HU, a Logitech C920, which is neither of which are currently working. back. Okay, good. My finger's in the right position. An MSI Gaming GTX 90. Oh, wait, it's not there. I left. Oh, wait, no, I didn't completely leave the video. Ta-da!
I'd have to say that those are probably your biggest fans.
Actually, I have a bigger one.
That's what she said.
Just casually dropping a 100 and, or not 100, 670 something dollar graphics card into a questionably anti-static bag. Yes, I spent that much money on a piece of equipment for computers. I'm weird.
You mean you pay retail? I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was tempted to spend like $900 on a brand new Asus graphics card.
That sounds like the 980 Ti ROG Platinum. I think. Or a Titan X. One of those two.
I am speaking on a professional studio quality microphone that does USB and analog as well. How much do you think this costed me?
$50.
Oh, just talking on the same one, too. You're right. You
there
actually
reasons, there's two reasons hit why I know that. I saw that exact one at Micro Center, and I read the post.
Well, that would do it. But not everybody who will ever be watching this video knew that, well, until now. But the point I'm making is, it's okay to not pay retail. You know, that's another dichotomy. People thinking that the more money you spend for something, the better it is. I'm sorry, but price gouging doesn't mean something is better. It just means you're getting bent over and fucked.
The bullshit meter has broken. It's gone up to 11. Actually, 12.
Hey, you know, the gasoline in downtown Chicago is usually about $1 to $2 more than the gasoline in my area. No, they can't be price gouging because it's a richy-rich area. They must somehow have better magical gasoline, because, you know, if it's more expensive, it must be better, right?
In New Jersey, it was $1.97.
When I was down in Florida, this was back in 2012, the gasoline down there, and this is when gas, mind you, was like, I think, $4 nearabouts in my hometown. It was like, I want to say like $1.53 in Florida, and that's just because they're down there near where all the oil wells and refineries are. Super cheap down there. Ridiculous how cheap it was down there.
Yeah, it's lately it's been about something like $2.60 around here.
Yeah, somewhere. It's been about the same price here, about $2.60, $2.40 somewhere in there.
Been about $2.30 where I live.
I kind of find it funny now how all the gas prices have really truly evened out from like coast to coast. Like, it's just totally kind of across the wall as to where it used to be. Depending on area, it would go from, like, you know, $1 to, like, $2, and then it'd go up to, like, skyrocketing near, like, $5 a gallon.
Yep, that would be California for you.
Chicago's always the most expensive gas in the state. Whatever the price is in Chicago, you can get it much cheaper in the suburbs.
Where would be the most expensive place in Maryland? That would probably be downtown Baltimore.
Ah, Baltimore, Maryland. Maybe he might have run into William Black in his dialogue.
Ew.
I guess I don't know what you're referencing.
You'd have to know you'd have to know the backstory on it.
Oh boy. No, I don't know the backstory on it. But I was in school when there were the more violent Freddie Gray riots, and we got out of school like 2 or 3 hours early.
Wow.
We're not in downtown, so we're actually quite far away. But is there logic? Better safe than sorry.
I just love how the mainstream makes a big deal over the Black Lives Matter thing, but then like 30,000 people show up at an All Lives Matter rally. No media coverage.
Bill O'Reilly be like, oh god, there's white people there supporting equality. This isn't right. That is a horrible Bill O'Reilly impression, especially the accent.
Alex Jones is a rapist and a woman sodomizer, and I'm Bill O'Reilly, and I'm telling you how it is. God damn it, this fucking thing sucks! Fuck! Fuck it! We're doing it live! This fucking thing sucks! Yeah, Bill O'Reilly's a fucking jackal. You guys are arrogant. I hate Bill O'Reilly.
My dad loves Bill O'Reilly and, like...
That figures.
Yeah, that totally figures. Takes a dick to love a dick.
Your dad's also a fascist fucking pig.
Yeah.
I mean, whenever I ask if you're going to your dad's house today, you know that I never ask, are you going to your dad's house? I ask whether or not you're going to Hitler's today.
I am today.
Now the question is he liberal enough to have Wi-Fi?
No, he actually does have Wi-Fi, but it's... It's horrific.
Graphics card, can you facepalm me real quick? No? Oh, no? Okay. I'm going to do the thing from Monty Python, the monks, where they would just take their books and go, remember, do you know what I'm talking about?
I've never seen Monty Python, but you're not the first person to reference that to me, or around me. Yeah.
You are all individuals! We are all individuals! You can think for yourselves! We can think for ourselves!
The irony.
There's a lot. Yeah, he has his smartphone now, so he thinks that means we shouldn't get Wi-Fi in our house at all ever. And I'm like, no, that's not true. I have a laptop that I could get a lot of use out of if it had Wi-Fi.
Hey, fuck, What do you think the smartphone uses, dickhole? You think the internet just magically comes in as unicorns and pixies in the fifth dimension, like, rape your phone and inject their magical Wi-Fi goo into it? Or do you think maybe there's a service that your phone connects to, dumbass? No, maybe it connects to this early 1990s memory chip here. Maybe it's a SIM card, a magical SIM card. Yes,
Are you raped by unicorns? No? Oh, okay, you can go back into my pocket.
This is a 32-pin SIM. Let's see how big of a geek you are. 32-pin SIM.
Oh my god.
Yeah, because I sent it. You bitch.
I got a whole bunch of them right here. These things. Yep. One of these has my birth year on it, 1995. It's as old as I am. And it's like, holy crap, that puts shit in perspective.
This is a 72-pin SIM, which I also gave him a few of.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, right here.
Hello.
Old memory. Very old. Where's that one with my birthday? Here it is, Viking Components, copyright 1995.
But if you want,
it's 20 years old.
Yeah, but if you want 30-pin Sims or 32-pin Sims, I got a whole big ass container of them right here, and I have two containers of the 72-pin.
I somehow ended up with a deleted Intel Pentium 4, so gaze over its deletedness.
Here's the.
Oh God, it's still sticky.
And they're like flying out and trying to attack me because they're angry. Here's the 72 pin chips.
Yeah, so, I don't have anything nearly that old.
they're just mad because they're obsolete now. They're hating.
Day was mad.
They're hating. Then, of course, okay, now we can have some real fun. I got a lot of antique stuff here. Here is an Intel 486 DX2 processor. Let's see, how many megahertz are you? Oh, it's a DX2 66, so 66 megahertz. Ta-da!
Oh, wow. That's cool.
486.
Oh, wow, that's an old.
Oh, yeah.
Piece of tech there. Dang.
I have a Raspberry Pi. Actually, I have three Raspberry Pis. One's in my closet, and two are in... Oh, God. Reach. Wow.
This is older than the moss growing on Kristen's dad's brain from lack of use.
I don't think it's just moss, frankly. I think it's some sort of nuclear-powered mushroom.
Or maybe somebody skull-fucked him and there's a little bit of jizz up him.
Or it's one of those, if anybody's watched Futurama, it's one of those green brain slugs that's attached to his skull that's sending transmissions into his brain going, "Everyone needs a brain slug. Brain slugs are good for people."
It's probably that.
And he's just sitting there, you know, totally brain dead. One eye's like off in one direction, and the other eye's like over in the opposite direction. He's just like tongue sticking out and drooling. I agree. Here is a Frankie hat for you, and it's just another brain slug.
And one of these days I'm going to be getting a Raspberry Pi. I haven't gotten around to it yet.
I love that.
Actual Raspberry Pi.
This $35 Raspberry Pi or $35 edible Raspberry Pi?
The actual edible Raspberry Pi, because I don't really know the technological Raspberry Pi.
The non-edible one will last longer, and you can use it more than once.
What is the Raspberry Pi good for? What does it do?
Well, that is a lovely... Let me pull it out of its little box. I love... It's the size of a credit card.
Show us your package.
So... Oh, I forgot it had one of a little micro SIM card in there.
They have cases for them, too. I know that.
Yeah, I have one. I haven't opened it yet. No, wait. Yes, I did.
Here is my Amazon Fire HD7 with 16 gigs of memory.
I don't have a tablet, mostly because my laptop can double as a tablet.
Well, I got this iCraig here. I mean, it's not as good as an Amazon Fire, you know, 16 gig, but, you know, it does the job. Works pretty well.
Cool.
It's pretty good.
So let's see. You asked what a Raspberry Pi can do. So, it's a computer, Ethernet, four USB 2.0s. It has a quad-core processor, clocked at 900 megahertz. Has 1 gigabyte of RAM. It runs Linux distros, HDMI, micro, micro USB type B.
It's got Wi-Fi and LAN.
No, just LAN. No Wi-Fi.
Oh, really? I thought it had too.
That might be the Odroid. Or Odroid. That's the extraordinarily expensive credit card size one. I will probably be using one of these to build a drone. Or something like that. Because one of my random crazy ideas was, hey, I have a 30-pound backpack. How about I build a robot to take it for me? Now comes the issue of, hey, the doors are not the quote-unquote wheelchair accessible kind. Crap, that's not good. I'm going to have to engineer an arm for it to open doors. If it could go back into the bag, that'd be great.
Stephanie, more input.
Or you could build yourself quad. Or you could build yourself a quadcopter.
No, I didn't.
With a nice rotational gimbal camera.
Has nobody seen Short Circuit?
I have Short Circuit too, but I have yet to sit down and actually watch it.
That's the voice I was doing. Robot. Johnny Five, need more input, Stephanie. Input.
Yes. I now know what you're referencing. Yes, I do. Oh. MicroSD. I did not tell you to go. I love it how I'm talking to a microSD card.
No disassemble! No disassemble! Johnny Five is alive!
People are going to be watching this later and be like, what did I just click on?
That's been a majority of any PSEC hangout. If it wasn't that way, I'd be a little bit concerned. Or they're going to say a bunch of nobodies watched it, and my big crimson black cock is so butthurt, I don't even know what I'm doing. And I bet he probably still follows us around like a little bitch, too.
Well, Crimson Flake hasn't stalked me yet. Apparently, that's been a privilege bestowed.
It doesn't mean that he isn't like looking on YouTube and shit like that. He might not be following us on DA, but that doesn't mean he isn't periodically checking in.
I just realized looking into the into my own video feed how drunk I look. I'm just like,
Channel before it was taken down by the censorship Nazis, I had over 6,000 subscribers and over 6 million views. So when Crimson Flake was like, oh, no, nobody likes your stupid videos anyway, it's like, oh, okay. 6 million nobodies.
Right. And then, of course, there's that one chick who called and said that we're like an inspiration and we're awesome. And, you know, they sit down in sessions and watch our stuff.
Lucy Rose.
Yeah.
She was talking to us as a private conversation. She was not a hangout, but she was saying that, like, you know, she'll open up PSEC videos and Max Egan, well, mainly those two, and, like, there's all these chicks she'll get together with, like, physically in person for, like, little, you know, video watching sessions, and it'll either be, you know, one of ours or one of Max Egan's. Because apparently she knows a lot of women that are feeling very disempowered, and, you know, Lucy likes what, you know, we have to say about empowerment and stuff, and apparently our videos make these ladies feel better, so hello, ladies, if you're watching.
Here's the drunken thumbs up. No, I'm not dead. Just getting the most amazing amount of glare.
As long as we're doing 80s retro stuff, gotta do it right.
Much. Nope, still glaring in my face. Not great.
Now I've got my 80s retro glasses.
I love technology. I'm talking to you guys on one screen, I'm multitasking on another screen, and with my tablet, I am currently watching the International Space Station live stream feed as it is going overhead around the Earth.
Ooh. So you're a fan of NASA?
You should check.
He only runs the NASA headquarters group on DeviantArt, but no.
Yeah, you should.
Oh, right.
If you've been looking a little closer, yeah, you would have noticed that my main group is in fact. Yeah.
I'm at least a watcher of that. I think I'm a member of that. I'm not entirely sure.
I don't know if you can see my background here. Some of my background, I mean, yeah, I got a Soviet flag there, but I also have a
Russia
NASA thing there on my wall. It's got all the different patches, and then I got other stuff in the background that you can't see that's NASA related on my walls as well.
Because Rochelle was apparently unable to make it, we have instead Seashell.
Badunch.
No Rochelle, but we had Seashell. Oh, look, my head is a Seashell. Just give me long hair and call me a wraith.
If there's Stargate an inside joke here, I'm not getting it.
Stargate Atlantis, you'll get it when you end up watching the series.
Yeah.
You'll get to it.
Starting to get that reference, but not all there yet.
Hey, I'm only on season 5 right now. I'm like on season 5, episode 6. It's like Rite of Passage is the name of the episode. It's where a much older... what's her name? Much older girl that they pulled off of a planet that got genetically, virally bombed by a Nirti. What was that girl's name?
Cassandra,
that's it. Yeah, Cassandra. Yeah, off this planet. But anyway, she's like 16 or something, and when I saw this episode last night, I'm like, holy crap! What the hell happened?
So many strange things happen in space, it's not even funny. Like my Russian accent. Badunch.
Oh,
I see graphics card.
No.
Oh.
It's a RAID controller, although you can put the drives in singular mode. It'll support 8 drives.
All the RAID. Let's see, what do I just have lying around? I have a box of just old computer parts. I broke a motherboard once.
I have 2 of these.
Hey, at least you didn't pull the German keyboard kid and totally rage out because the game wasn't loading, and then he gets absolutely raped multiple times on the game, and he's like, Voshna! Ah! And then he starts beating his keyboard, and he's like, ah! And he's crying and stuff, and it's like, dude, good thing that was one of those older computers that had, like, the solid screen made of glass, so you couldn't...
Oh, no kidding.
Because that kid would have smashed his screen, too.
Did you see the video? I think it was on, it was... Oh, shoot. Which channel was it on? I've already forgotten. But a kid was doing some video for, like, an airsoft thing or something like that. I think it was for a school project. And he didn't know he thought his airsoft gun wasn't loaded, and he pulled the trigger for some reason, and he shot his own monitor.
No.
And that dumb, is why...
Dumb, dumb, dumb,
stupid.
And that is why I think it is best to teach kids about real firearms before you hand them a toy, because at that point, they'll handle the toy like they handle a real firearm. Treat it as if it is always loaded. Never treat it as if it is unloaded. Never have your finger on the trigger if you're not intending to shoot, etc. Because when you handle real firearms, there are rules, there are customs, there are things you have to abide by. You know, you keep the gun pointed in a direction that where there are no people. You make sure that, you know, it's unloaded. You always double check to make sure it's unloaded when you pick it up. Things of that nature.
Oh, and that is why I'm not saying we should kill all the stupid people, but I am saying if we remove all the warning labels, we let the problem take care of itself.
Warning, if you're an idiot, you will die.
I mean, hell, handling firearms common sense. It's common sense stuff. It's not rocket science. It's not some magically possessed little, you know, gremlin that's in there that's gonna like magically cause the gun to levitate and like shoot you. I mean,
Schmiedel precious is not precious.
The voice was so high.
And this obviously is an IDE controller, so imagine if I had like 8 1-terabyte IDE drives and I could hook them all up to there.
You said you had a 27-terabyte mass storage thing?
Mostly external drives, hooked up via ESATA and USB 3. In the next incarnation of my file server, most of those are going to go internal. The motherboard's going to have 4 SATA ports, and I'm going to put in another card for another 4, so that'll be 8 right there. And then I'll be able to put in 8 IDE. So by default, internally, the computer is going to end up with 16 hard drives and then whatever else I need to put on the external.
The computer back there, the non-working box that I broke the US... I didn't break it, I just bent something. I keep saying I break it, things when I actually didn't. Phone, could you be quiet? Oh, wait. Oh, I know what notification that was. I'm going to call MSI, which is a motherboard company, and I'm a little annoyed because they used to make black and blue motherboards and now they don't make black and blue motherboards. I was like... And now just awkward silence.
Not awkward, just silence. Silence is only awkward if you choose to perceive it as such.
As my friends always say, Daniel, you only make the awkward silence awkward when you say it's awkward. Which I tend to say that a lot.
Guilty.
It's mostly because I hate it when people stop talking. It's just you're like,
I don't like it after something that I say.
It's even worse. You're just like, that happened in the middle of class. It just went dead silent. Even the teacher was saying, stop saying something. I was like,
oh.
If you want to talk, now would be a great time. All of us, you know. Yeah, you two, I know you two talk a lot during class. You can contribute now. Yeah, you can do that.
Now's the time.
Just dropping a big old bomb of sarcasm.
Yeah. And when I'm in those situations, part of my social anxiety is like, it's always me that I feel is the one who should be the person to think of something to say. And if I don't, I start to get really annoyed with myself, like, why can't I think of anything to say?
Or why can't you just sit back and relax and just enjoy being there in the group and not think that you have to talk endlessly nonstop, otherwise it means you're doing something wrong or something? It doesn't mean you're doing anything wrong.
You are not talking endlessly. You fail.
You have reached failure. You have stopped talking. How dare you?
You kept talking in one incredibly unbroken sentence, moving from topic to topic so that no one could interrupt him. It was really quite hypnotic. Rich should know where that's from.
Welcome to the class of standing up. And you fail.
I get that reference.
ASDF.
Yep. I think it was...
Well,
no, it was...
You might enjoy PSEC 2015 ASDF, a not-so-educational parody.
I think it was, hello and welcome to Standing Up School. Whoosh! And you fail.
Yeah.
You fail.
And you can tell I've rehearsed that quite a bit because I've tried to nail the British accent. Tried to. Whenever there is an awkward silence, like, I've had to... I don't find speaking in front of a great deal of people as a scary thing. It's just the... I saw that glitch, I'm like,
There we go.
Oh! I saw screenception there happen. It was like
Yeah. Now here's my Linux system here, and I've got the main list of partitions opened up on the massive file server that I was just mentioning. I didn't open up too many subdirectories because I don't want to go completely nuts and that would take forever. But I'm just going to do a slow scroll here so that you can just kind of see why exactly, you know, 27 terabytes might possibly be needed. Just tell me.
So many folders.
Oh, look, it's a comedy clip of themes under audio.
Oh, boy.
Give it a second here. Do-do-do-do-do. Loading.
Kristen, yeah, I know how you said you wanted to, you wanted to, but not wanted to at the same time. I'm confusing myself. Do a YouTube channel thing?
Yes.
The question becomes, wait, I'm going to sound like a complete salesman here. Do you have a good computer for it? Salesman mode has been activated.
Yes, actually she does. I refurbished it for her and installed Linux on it myself.
Ah, nerd high five.
Yeah. I haven't used it too much, but I have started learning a little bit, you know, with the softwares and stuff. And, yeah.
Hey, Daniel, are you still watching the screen?
Oh, screen share.
It just keeps going and going and just.
Oh yeah, I saw this the other night. Yeah, the 27 terabytes of just.
Yeah. Oh look, YouTube channels. Boom.
God.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Other channels that he's downloaded.
Something I would do. I just don't have. I'm using, because my desktop is still not working, only has 128 gigabytes of storage, and...
Oh, Dave, speaking
of... Are you able to read that? Look at the movie stuff.
Oh, my God.
1930 to 1949.
Did you just say, hey, here are movies from this era, I'm going to download all of them?
Oh, and look, TV movies in series. Watch what happens when I click that.
Loading...
Star Wars, Smurfs, X-Men, the whole
thing. Oh, and, you know how I was mentioning that I've been watching Stargate Atlantis? Let's see, Stargate, Boing, Stargate Atlantis.
Folders and folders.
Boom. SGU. SG-1.
And another thing that would be really cool, well, I have this other video that you want, I know you probably want, It's a 2 hour, 16 minute, and 14 second video, and it is titled The Lost Archives, NASA's Mercury, Gemini, and Apollo Missions in 1080p, 60 frames per second, high definition.
Send that to me, too, while you're at it. My dad works at NASA. I'm a bit of a space nerd as well.
Your dad works at NASA?
Yes, he does.
Oh,
wow.
Small world. I did not know that. Well, in that case, I'll make you an admin in my group.
There's one issue, though.
Yeah?
I'm not a core member, and I'm already admin of three groups.
I see. Decisions.
I can fix that. There is a group that I am part of that is, like, doesn't do anything.
Well, if it's a dead group, it's a dead group.
Yeah, because the person who started it deleted their account. And I never understood why. She said there were, like, family issues. I'm like, I'm going to be that one guy. I like dancing. I like trains.
Yeah, as far as I'm concerned with that group, just jump ship.
Yeah, I already did. I just did.
Oh.
I would be... Here's my mentality. I would be the one guy who would find the last post, see which IP address it launched from, go through DeviantArt's servers, find it, and then ask for a location ping, and then find out where she lives. That does not sound creepy in the slightest bit now, does it?
Nah, not at all.
As I smile in quite possibly the weirdest way ever.
Well, apparently, seeing as you like ASDF, I know you've been kind of limited on time, so you haven't seen most of the videos, so you probably haven't seen ASDF, a non-educational parody that we did.
Nope.
And I think Kristen was trying to say something, or was I imagining that?
I just was saying I love ASDF movies.
So would you like me to show this to you, seeing as you apparently like ASDF? This is like our own little insane take on things.
I have to talk to my dad's.
Have fun in the fascist no Wi-Fi.
So you're
going to Hitler's Reich, aka Daddy's house.
But actually, it's gonna be nice tonight because we're gonna get Mexican food.
Oh, by the way, don't forget to bring your laptop over there. Because seeing as I loaded it up with like so much content that you feel like you have an internet connection even when you're not internet connected, that'll keep you from going into massive depression of having nothing else better to do over there.
Yeah, if my parents were divorced, which they're not, and one of them did not have internet, I would probably scream, amongst other things. I'd probably find a way to binge off of the neighbor's Wi-Fi. Completely illegally.
I also loaded up her laptop with all sorts of cool educational stuff, and seeing as Hitler is a dumbass and hates educational stuff, all she's got to do to, like, get him to leave her alone is he'll be like, what are you doing? She'll be like, oh, I'm watching, like, a 2-hour educational documentary on this. Want to watch it with me, Dad? No, that's okay. I'll just leave you to it.
What does your dad do? I'll try to be as unoffensive as possible, which is...
That's alright. He is basically, his whole life is hell-bent on being just miserable. He's always complaining about things, and he doesn't like that I have different ideas about how the world is than he does. And as far as what he actually does, currently unemployed, he plays horseshoes and cars, but
What does he do? I think he was asking, what does he do that's frickish and Hitlery? not like employment, but like, you know, what does Mr. Fuhrer do to enforce his Reich?
Both, actually.
Well, he is very, like, head games and blackmail-y and
breaking promises.
If he thinks there's something, he does anything that he can to extend his control over me as a parent. And it's like, he's not lenient about visiting, saying, be at my house at this exact minute's late. He tries to pull huge guilt trips with me, and I'm like, okay, well, at least we're having visitations at all. And
look at the amount of this is how I envision you or someone else in that situation.
I find it funny that he gets mad at you when you don't believe him on something, and it's like, Dad, but you're a notorious liar. I never know when you're actually telling me the truth. You say you're going to do something, then you don't. It's like, and then you're pissed when I don't believe you. It's like, but you're always full of shit. What do you expect?
Yeah. My question is, does he think he's superior to everyone else?
Oh, God, yeah.
Yes,
I mean, I don't know the guy, but Kristen told me it, like, at length.
He thinks he is superior to everyone else, and anyone who meets him will eventually get the same opinion of him, which is this. He thinks that he is the center of the world and that people should make their plans around him and that they should cater to him. And I think that deep down, he feels very small, but he overcompensates for that shit by being the
largest douchebag on the face of the planet.
Yeah.
And she thinks that Kristen having normal civil conversations with older guys is creepy, yet he doesn't think anyone would think him to be a pedophile for hitting on Kristen's friends. Yeah.
Oh.
How many times? Those people. I can't tell you how many rants I've gone on about wanting to put a bullet in the back of that guy's head.
I wonder if he's met my grandfather, because my grandfather is like, I remember in Ukraine and what was the other country? It was I've forgotten. It was part of Nazi Germany.
It was okay in Ukraine for me. It's okay for you here in the States. You also must have my sheep.
Actually, no. It because I remember some little thing from my childhood in Nazi-controlled, I don't know where, I've already forgotten. Therefore, it should be same here, because I am a racist asshole. little known fact, my great-great, it's either my great or great-great-grandfather was fighting for the Nazi side.
Oh, fun.
Yeah. The awkwardness. It's just like,
I can imagine your grandfather. Black person, here's a watermelon. Now wash my car.
I don't think he gets the watermelon reference. He looks at Obama, he's just like, how did we elect that man? I'm like, well, George W. Bush was an idiot, so we didn't want somebody as dumb.
Well, there's always the same controlling hand up every puppet president's ass.
See, I did say as. Well, I think that when people want to bag on Obama, it's like, okay, there's so many things that you could say about him other than his race or he's not even actually American. Like, if that's for one thing, the whole American thing isn't even true. And all you have to say about him as a president, like, there's things that you could actually, valid points that you could make as to why he sucks.
Yes,
there is proof that he is from Kenya, and the reason you have to be a natural-born citizen is to prevent, foreign takeover through foreign influence. political structure, but the problem there is Wall Street is made up of all the foreign billionaires who are hell-bent on power and control and destruction and genocide. So the United States has already been taken over by foreign interests, making it a moot point as to where Obama is from.
Yep, pretty much.
Citizen.
Barack Obama's birth certificate that they quote unquote released has been proven, and I've seen the footage of them going through Photoshop and literally taking that thing apart piece by piece by piece. It's a fraud.
Yeah.
They've literally taken that birth certificate apart. And not only that, I've heard interviews with his grandmother talking about how he was born in Kenya. You know, being at Jomo Kenyatta Hospital when he was born, and Jomo Kenyatta Hospital is in Nairobi, mind you, which is in Kenya. And his own personal accounts of how he was born how he was raised for a time in Malaysia, and he would listen to the Muslim prayer imams in the morning, and, you know, how the call from the tower was the prettiest sound in the world. He said that shit out loud.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, he's playing on people's ignorance to not look into it.
Exactly.
He'll make a secondary statement. I mean, he did the same thing with the Iraq war, pulling out of Iraq not being his idea. He went around for months and months and months and months and months, over and over and over and over and over and over and over again, saying, there are no troops in Iraq. That was my idea. There are now no troops in Iraq. That was my idea. And then when the media, when it becomes the exact opposite and the decision that he made was a poor one in the long run because they funded ISIS and now ISIS is now running across Syria with CIA backers, you know, he's like, I just find it funny how the media thinks pulling out of Iraq was my idea. You know, he just changes tactics, and people who don't pay attention more than, you know, 2 weeks worth of news, you know, and let everything else just fade off in distant memory and never to be paid attention to again, you know, just eat it up like, oh, well, it's gospel.
Kidding. Plus, Obama admits in his own book that he was born in Kenya. Plus, I've seen speeches from when he was a senator where he openly admits he was born in Kenya. And I've seen his wife admit that he was born in Kenya. So it's like, you know, this isn't like some hearsay that's about him. This is right out of his own mouth.
What I always find, does anyone here remember the carnival ship lines accident where they, or the boat lost power and it was stranded in sea for, I think, 4 days. Anyone remember that?
No.
The
only reason I remember that is I was reading an article back then in USA Today, and they said Americans have a short they said how this was affecting the economy around that sort of thing, and they said Americans have a short memory span. Give this a year and nobody will remember that. And that is the only reason I remember that article. How many years ago was it? 3 years, 4 years ago now? I think it was at least three. And that's the only reason I remember that is because it's just like, oh yeah, we have really, really shitty memory regarding these things.
Well, we're narrow-minded. I mean, we're taught to only focus on what we're being indoctrinated in right now. The educational system is basically shit in, shit out. Memorize, regurgitate, repeat.
Oh yeah, I have an awful attention span. Like, I'll go do something for 5 minutes, then I have to do something else for 5 minutes. It's just crazy. Like, it took me at least an hour to read through one of your comments. I'm just like, good God, how did he write that freaking paragraph? Not that that's anything against you, I'm just saying. I'm just like, wow,
yeah.
He really hates the U.S., school systems.
Well, it's easy to be able to write and rant on that stuff because, again, it's just all about being authentic. I think that a quote-unquote lack of attention span is really just a symptom of a lack of confidence. And also, when you have someone that has a mind that is capable of efficiently multi-threading information, and that person is told, oh no, you have to always narrow your mind down to this one thing only, you can't let things flow in parallel, then instead of multi-threading the information, the data is always going into collision instead of coexisting. So in order to try to avoid the brain pain of the collision, the person tries to constantly shift their attention span from one thing to another because they've been taught that they can't multi-thread the data. But actually they can. It's just that, you know, they've been taught to believe in a crock of shit.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and head on over to my dad's. So, nice meeting you, Daniel.
Nice meeting you, too.
My cousin's name is Daniel.
Yeah.
We're obviously not cousins.
Yeah.
That would be really cool, though.
Yeah, just randomly cousins with someone I end up meeting.
Unless you wanted to date him, then it would be creepy if you were cousins.
Yeah.
Very.
I have a bunch of relatives that I don't know about. My dad was adopted, and we didn't know about his birth parents, so I hope to find out.
Can fucky 10 million people for less?
Actual, like, family heritage and meet relatives. Said Dave. I got, like, two little bits of it.
Oh, I said, Ken Fucky! 10 million people, 4 last names.
Oh, it's so true, though. There are 3 people there in my school. There's, like, there's at least 3 groups of people that have the same last name, and none of them are Smith. Oh, I think General Tate's video. I think his browser crashed again.
There
are ridiculous last Smith. All right.
Thank you, Kristen, for joining us.
Same. This has been fun.
Yes, it has. We will definitely have to do this again soon.
Hopefully I can join you guys again. Eventually, I don't know when. It's the great thing called my homework schedule. And it's just like, oh, you wanted free time? Nope, I'm going to be a dick, and you have none.
It's not a schedule, actually. It's more accurately represented by, if you imagine a big dump truck and imagine it filled with homework, then imagine you're at the rear of the dump truck, and now the dump truck lifts up its, you know, back, and all the homework just comes right down on top of you. That's not a schedule. That's just piling crap on you.
Yeah, this is what I like to do. I like to put a little bit of flair behind my, shall we say, vulgarities. It's like, homework, what was I going to do? Yeah, there was something I was thinking of. Oh, yeah. that was fairly uninventive, but oh well. I think you were going to show me the ASDF thing.
Yeah, seeing as you said you
liked it.
You're a big fan of ASDF, and you were apparently unaware that we did ASDF and also Educational Parody.
I think I saw it, but I didn't click on it because it was like 8 in the morning and I had to go to school. Wait, it wasn't 8 in the morning, it was 6:20 in the morning.
Well, either way, you had other things you were doing.
as in commuting to school, that hour and a half long commute. I just love it.
And this video is not—it's not all that long, so you know it'll fit in here without a problem.
Yeah, it's 20 minutes. No big deal.
Yeah. Let's see. General Tate has returned. Okay. Anyway, I'll just go ahead and play this. I'm sure you'll get a kick out of it.
I like singing.
I like dancing.
I like trains.
Hello, Mind Turtle.
Perfect, thank you.
If you really want enlightenment, then just lighten up.
Screw gravity.
Hello again, Turtle.
Suddenly, pineapples.
Remember, it's Armageddon Turtle.
Hello, my turtle.
It does not expect you to have to, in any way, shape, or form, suffer.
Circumstances don't matter. Only state of being a matter.
The prop guy.
I do the flop.
Oh.
Let's think about Aladdin and the sexual game.
Rainbow.
Okay, let's not. That's a little creepy.
What the f*** is this?
Oh, that's what you could have been saving if you had Geico.
Geico? Who wants Geico?
Oh, no. I am not stepping on you.
It's the money you could be saving with Geico. Even after this commercial ends, he'll be here waiting. He just wants you to save money.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
The Western Church arose to a position of supreme power, kingmaker, landowner, and purveyor of the truth. The Church took it upon themselves to be the one knower of everything. The dogma was law. Yet science had moved forward, and now challenged the dogma that the Earth was the center of the universe.
How did I do the flop?
What are you up to, son? Yes, you do.
Overall strategy for America in this period, when really a new world order can be created, it's a great opportunity.
No, I'm allergic to adorableness!
That would be the most flattering compliment I've ever received.
I swear. I'm gonna do an internet!
Sometimes I can be a little bit too hard on myself, and that's not necessarily, like, the most easy thing for me to admit, but it really is probably one of the most true things. I have, like, unreasonable expectations of myself sometimes, and just because I've learned a lot of things, I expect myself to retain all that knowledge at all times and not be a human, almost like a robot. I used to wish I was a robot when I was a kid. It's really weird.
Feed me paper.
Answer the damn phone. I am the Prince of Darkness. I need the souls. I command thee to give me your souls. Hello.
I like your mom when I'm banging her. What do you like?
I like trains.
No, wait.
How about you do the flop? Can I do the flop?
Well, at least we'll have the sincere knowledge that he won't be having children again.
And now, the funniest thing you've ever seen, from really far away.
A transition is about to occur, a dimensional shift that will lessen the density of the third dimension, so that you will move into higher dimensions in which the body does not have such a solid state.
Why wait?
New is paradigm. You pretend you're happy, but you're always so sick.
So sick.
People mention it, you claim they're a dick. You get back what you put out, of this have no doubt.
The internet be like.
Maybe Dave went dead. I'm still here.
Okay. Going to casually sink into my chair. If he did pause the video on purpose, I wonder. There's two things I wonder. If he's still recording and he's wondering, I wonder how these two people are going to react when I'm not here.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Whatever works, you know?
And now we wait.
Let's see.
Let's see if he'll respond on DeviantArt. If not, then we might.
Random.
Whoop.
Oh, he dropped out. Yep, it's just me and you now. Yep, we got to keep the show alive. Got to keep it going.
Just random. Keep it going.
Videos that are funny and with no sound because I don't want YouTube to third copyright party match.
The party matching.
Yeah, you play it with sound, they get really nasty.
You're just like, how dare you? How dare you? Yeah. Okay, that was weird.
Nah, it wasn't weird. It's just, we gotta find shit to do until, and or unless. now it's our video. This is interesting. Okay, random videos that are funny. Random stupid funny videos compilation 2014 top fails.
Do I want to see matching? Oh god.
Let's do some Gary's mod. Those are random.
Which YouTubers do you follow?
Too many to name. I'm going to do default view too, so that way they don't bash me for it. Hopefully, if things will allow, maybe we have to.
Oh, I hate the buffer symbol. Absolutely despise it. Despise it in all of its bufferingness.
Yeah, it tends to suck. But it could just be because I'm screen sharing at the same time and I have my tablet going, which is hogging off of bandwidth, so...
Oh, how I... Let's see. What does my internet look like at the what at the moment?
Here's my. This isn't really funny.
Begin test. How I love Ookla speed test. It says I'm in the middle of the Chesapeake Bay.
Oh, it's funny. My internet always generally, at least with my old service provider, it always said I was clear up in Eugene, which I'm not. Which I think is kind of funny.
Yeah, that's
elsewhere.
Yeah, that's the one issue with using your IP address as your location, is it gives you maybe the county you're in or someplace like that, and then it's not much more accurate than that.
Oh, for me, it's, dude, this city's in another county. It's like 100 miles north of me.
Or oh.
It was. I don't know what my current location is now. I don't know what the automatic, I don't know if it can detect where I'm at now, but at least with my old ISP, that's the way it was. It was like,
it probably can't, because so many, what I find very funny is when people say they're worried about, what is a valid, worry is when people are tracking your browsing. That's perfectly fine to worry about. When people worry about their location and they say in laptops, I just, do you know how GPS and IP addresses work?
Yeah, GPS. They're like two different things.
GPS is you know, relies on satellites. IP addresses are just, we know you're in this general location in, like, you know, this 30 mile, 20 mile radius.
Oh, here's the good shit. The Idiots of Gary's Mod.
Uploaded in 2007.
Classic. Come on. You know what? I'm going to shut off my tablet. It's causing problems. See if that helps.
You can always run an Ookla speed test on that. Will tell you how fast it's going, and I can't tell you what's going on with it, but it can tell you how.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to part two. I know we were in the middle of kind of giving a bit of a preview of a little ASDF parody before, but then my internet decided to take like one of the weirdest shits ever. It went down for a while, then it came back up, but it would only let me use Skype and things like that. Nothing web-based would resolve at all. I mean, I could get into the web interface from my router and everything, but nothing else would resolve, and it was really weird, and I had to keep, like, you know, shutting down my modem and router for a while, bringing it back up, messing with things. Finally, everything kicked back into gear. Richard's getting some food, and you've only got, like, 30 minutes left anyway. So, you know, Daniel's over there just getting a little pussy. He's got his cat over there with him.
We left my lap.
Oh, the pussy was in your lap. You were stroking the pussy and everything, you know, kind of doing, looking for that little bit of, you know, public action there with the getting some pussy on cam. There's pussy on cam.
Say hello, Oreo.
Yeah, I've got Pumpkin Ball, Fluffy, and Sandy.
We actually
not directly with me. They're elsewhere at the moment.
So I'm just curious, what did you actually have to do to get your router and everything, or your interwebs back functioning?
Well, all I did, like I just said, is I just, you know, shut it off for a bit, turned it back on, kept repeating the process until eventually just decided to click in. So anyway, when I finally came back in, although the recording had completely stopped by this time and YouTube saying, fuck you, I'm not going to continue it. And right before you had to leave, you were talking about something about DeviantArt and Amazon.com and something like that. Like, I only like got part of it. Like,
that conversation. It was quite funny when you dropped out and GeneralTate and I were just like, okay, Dave's gone. that was funny. So what we were talking about is I threw out a suggestion that, and I've actually had this on my mind for quite a while, is some sort of program I'm sure you've encountered this before, is when people will threaten their own lives for some reason or another over the web, whether it be DeviantArt, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, whatever. I just started taking a computer science course this year, and the hidden reason behind that one was to actually start learning code to write a program or virus or worm that is able to go through DeviantArt, go through their go through DeviantArt, find the persons who sent out the that journal or deviation or status update, and ping their location. Now, there's two issues with that. One is because DeviantArt used to own its own own and maintain its own servers, and what was really funny is one of their IT guys, his name is Sasha, and he was Russian, referencing the earlier thing we were doing. But now they moved out of that, and right now, nowadays they are running off of Amazon Web Services. So Amazon, it's not like Amazon bought DeviantArt. Like, it's just that DeviantArt, I guess, got tired of running its own servers because there were so many issues. You can imagine having to run keep at least 500 machines running properly. That would be hell. They bought some. So now they run on Amazon Web Services. So there comes the issue where, if you actually want to ping somebody's location, first you have to get through DeviantArt's website, and then you have to go into Amazon. Then you have to get an admin. Get an admin password and admin access. Then find out who was which IP address sent it out, and then you have to figure out which computer or phone or tablet or desktop on that IP address sent out the.
I think the method to your madness that you are going with this is make a program that could track that and send that information off to local authorities. But because they did this little switch, that now makes that much harder to do.
Yes, the thing is, it's like, okay, if you were just hacking through DeviantArt servers, it's like, okay, it's illegal. And then when you're doing it to DeviantArt and then Amazon, then you're like doubling up the illegality. Especially if it's Amazon, it's like, you don't want to get in trouble with it.
Yeah, well then, I guess the only thing that you'd be able to do is if you were a good enough coder and could approach Amazon, just be like, look, I want to make this program that, you know, scans through and looks for, you know, suicide posts and, you know, gets the IP information and then, you know, emails that to whatever authorities are local to that IP with a direct link to the, you know, suicide thing, so that the local authorities could then, you know, handle it appropriately And then Amazon might go, well, if you're willing to code that, then okay, we can let you do that.
I think it would be not only just Amazon. I would have to go, because Microsoft does web service hosting. You'd have to go to them. You'd have to go to DeviantArt. If you were doing that on other social media websites, you have to go to like Twitter, Facebook.
Of course. You'd have to start somewhere.
Yeah, it would.
If you started with Amazon and they're like, okay, sure, you could do that, then you set a precedence, and then you could go to other places and go, well, Amazon let me do that, and here's how it's been working out for us so far. Would it be, would you like to hook into this system as well? And if so, how would you like us to do that? Because obviously hacking you is illegal, so you have to give us a way in.
Yeah, that's the, and then GeneralTate, when he and I were talking before, was he said, now the only issue with that is if someone with, say, someone on the dark web gets a hold of that source code, and I don't, it was I forget which website he was referencing. He said if somebody on that website got a hold of that source code, you have to you have a major crisis on your hands, because then people are able to ping others' locations
based on just about anything.
Mm-hmm.
Anything, any other criteria you want to stick in there?
Yeah.
Here's the thing, though, with code like that, that sort of stuff probably already exists on the dark web for nefarious purposes anyway. Because, I mean, obviously, if you could make something like that, then some much better and much more creepy coder probably already made exactly what you're worrying about them making. And they probably had that for, like, the last 20 years now. So
you can pull the same trick on them. You can say, hey, can I have, you can ask them, hey, do you have this type of code? And they can, you can ask them for that. The issue is it's dealing with shady people.
My point is that if you can think of it now, somebody else has already thought of it probably 15, 20 years ago, and has been doing it ever since. So you don't have to worry about that getting compromised, because it was compromised before you were born, so you don't have to worry about it.
Oh, yes.
Now you're using a more sort of code for a positive purpose.
Yeah. I'm sure. Now, the issue is I would definitely want to avoid publicity with this.
Yeah.
It's not that I hate being a public figure. It's not that I hate talking with people or public speaking. But it's this issue that you have all these, you have all these people that, I'm just going to say, we'll just take conservative Republicans, for instance. And I know this wouldn't be the only group of people, but it'd be a fairly surefire shot.
The Democrats and the Republicrats?
Anyone, really. I like to bash on the Republicans because it's a lot more fun. Or it's funny.
Well, I think it's two wings, one bird.
That's true.
They call it the right wing and the left wing. Let's put the analogy together. You got to figure it's one bird going like this. And the wings are all pretending to fight with each other when really it's just controlled opposition. It's like WWE wrestling. Doesn't matter whether or not Stone Cold or The Rock wins, because it's Vince McMahon's fucking company either way.
Exactly. Well, some of the, let's just say more, I'm not even going to reference the political parties or anything like that anymore. It would be people who have the improper idea about, or not improper, what am I saying? I sound like a moron.
In other words, people who like to blame the tools for everything instead of encouraging people to take responsibility for their actions and encouraging critical thinking and encouraging common sense, instead of encouraging that, they're like, ban everything because everything's bad and we should have a nanny state do everything for us and we shouldn't actually have any tools because we might hurt ourselves or others. So instead of teaching people how to actually do things properly, let's ban forks, let's ban knives, let's ban matches, let's ban guns, let's ban programs that have a positive purpose, but some people might use it negatively, and they probably already are. So all you're doing is banning the positive because the negative people are going to do it anyway.
Yeah, that's like one wing of it. And then the other wing of it I see is not banning it, but it's the people who are extraordinarily concerned about, say, their own security. And to be completely fair, as you've referenced so many times already, you've said that people, if somebody like me who has very, very little idea how to code, doesn't know exactly a lot about a lot of operating systems and such, can think of something like this, then there's probably already something used for nefarious purposes. I think people would not look at it that way, but they would look at it as a breach of their security and be ban it, but for a different reason. Because they'd be like, oh, I'm scared of being, like, stalked or looked over, which, to be fair, is, I guess, a valid concern, but...
But also a moot concern because there's already out there with that type of code that are already stalking, already looking over, already
yes.
nefarious shit. So it's like, seeing as that's already there and it's going to be there no matter what, and there ain't shit you can do about it, what you can do is use that same technology for positive means, since it's already being used ad nauseum for lots and lots of negative, nefarious things, whether people realize it or not. So why not use it for positive things?
Yeah, it's the same. I really can't think of an example off the top of my head, but I feel like it would be something Bill O'Reilly or another conservative, or actually it wouldn't even have to be a conservative. It would be anyone.
Video games are evil. They teach kids how to murder. We shouldn't have any video games. They're evil and they teach kids how to murder. And
yes.
Video games that are at fault. For the way society is right now. Really? So what version of the Xbox did they have during the 1400s? Please tell me.
The Xbox non-existent.
They had the abacus box.
Ooh, true. That reminds me of another thing. There was a story about 2 months ago where... these two Taiwanese immigrants had a child here. And have you ever heard the term tiger mom or tiger dad before? Have you ever heard that?
No.
It's a reference to, okay, let's say you got an A- on a test. They would say, oh, that's the same as an F. Sort of like completely downplaying your ability, completely sort of that.
In other words, ultimate control freak.
Yes.
That basically understands that the more berated and insecure they can make you feel, the more they can manipulate you, and thus the more they can manipulate you, the more they can power play you and put you under their control and do all sorts of mind games, basically exactly like what corporate-controlled government in league with the mainstream does to the entire population of the planet. So
exactly.
But on a much smaller scale. Tiger Big Brother.
So this girl, she never really had any chances to make friends. She would hardly ever go over to her friend's house. She always was doing some extracurricular activity, whether it be piano or something else. And
in order to not be at home to avoid the tyranny.
Exactly. That, and, well, her parents made her do those things. She never had any time to herself. Look at it that way. And so what she did is when her sophomore year of high school, her grades started slumping, and she was smart enough to print out fake report cards and tell her parents, "Oh, I'm still getting A's," while the school was saying, "No, you're getting C's and D's, and you're failing classes." She did graduate, and then, or did she graduate? Did she drop out of school? I've totally forgotten at this point. She graduated, I think, and then she faked getting into college. And then she faked that for 2 years, and then her dad found out, I think. Mm-hmm. And then her dad, like, I forget it. And then he did something to her or something like that. He basically disowned her. And then she knew a friend of hers that knew a hitman.
Ooh.
So she hired a hitman for $10,000 to kill both of her parents. The hitmen, there were three of them, killed the mom and severely wounded the father, which, and the way I tie this back into your point, the point about video games make kids violent, it's like, no, not entirely. If you show that, the reason why somebody was asking me, why did this person do that? And my answer is always, if you show people one extreme and the other extreme, then, or if you never expose somebody to one extreme, they're more likely to go to an extreme.
I think maybe the better way to say that is that all humans only operate based on what they know. So if they weren't shown love and compassion and support, and all they were ever shown is spite and neglect and contempt and hate and all the negative stuff, then they're probably most likely going to be a negative person. And negative people tend to do negative things. And when someone is really, 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 really negative, they're probably going to do really, 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 really negative things.
Yeah, it's like a cause and effect thing, but on a very large scale. I have never met a single person.
It's a fractal. You might say it's on a fractal scale.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is kind of symbiotically related to everything else.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of like how people, if you say that about video games, you like, I always hate bringing this argument up, but it's like when people will kill in the name of religion. I have nothing against religion, even though I myself am an atheist. I know there are plenty of churches who do amazing things, and I thank them for that. It's when
I think there's a difference between religion and spirituality.
Yes.
I think that Jesus was spiritual, and he preached heavily against religion, hence his warnings about the scribes and the Pharisees and all their mind games, you know, that he talks about in there. And look at the way modern organized religion is now.
It's, oh my God.
The same bullshit as back then, but on a grander scale. And Jesus was pointing at that going, "See those guys? They'll fuck with your head. You might want to stay away from that shit."
Which is kind of an ironic statement, considering they're following him, and then it's...
Yeah, and then...
It's a big, elaborate...
These spiritual teachings get hijacked and turned into a religion, and then twisted and mangled and manipulated and used as population control through fear.
Correct. And I always say the worst way to control a people and the worst way to control a child, or to control anyone, frankly, is through fear. And I'll bring up critical thinking, because it never allows that person to have critical thinking skills. It never allows them to do really anything with the
crush and indoctrination system, which is what the Prussian educational system, which is an indoctrination system, which our current system is based off of. And the one who created the Prussian system was also the father of neo-Nazism, which goes back to Hitler's quote, and I quote, "The beautiful thing about the totalitarian state is that it forces those who fear it to emulate it."
Yes, it's
you become what you fight.
Exactly.
Now, there's a difference between raging against something and self-defense. I'm not suggesting anybody bend over and be like, "Oh, well, I shouldn't fight, so I'm just gonna, yeah, okay, fuck me." Yeah, I'm not suggesting submitting to nefarious shit. I'm just saying that when you got that, like, rage that, like, "Yeah, fuck them, I hate them, ah," then it's like being drunk and on crack and on speed and on everything else all at once. The brain is in fight or flight. It goes to pudding. It can't think rationally. And you just become like a rat animal just attacking whatever, whoever. And that's the end result.
That was a great way of putting it. It turns to mush.
Yeah. Just, not recommended. It's just...
It's like getting high, but it's not... It's like getting high, but it retains all the sucky features.
Yeah, then, of course, there's the fake positive. Like, I'm positive, but shun the dark. If you look at the dark, you give power to it. And I'm like, okay, if you are judging the negative negatively, then isn't that being negative?
Just as judgmental.
How about looking at the negative as a positive opportunity for positive change? Like, for example, oh, look at that negative mess. This might just be a positive opportunity to clean up the mess, and maybe I'll even learn something in the process. That's a positive outlook, not like, oh, if I acknowledge the mess, I'm giving power to it. No. If you ignore the mess, it's rotting and developing bacteria and disease and spreading and festering, and little, you know, dangerous animals are laying their eggs in it, and, you know, and God only knows what. Just like if you ignore the roaches in the walls, they don't die. They breed.
It's not like, oh, there's a roach. I'm going, no, you're not there. You're not there. It's like, no, the roach doesn't disappear.
Kill that roach. I'm just going to ignore it out of existence. That's what I'm going to do. I'll show that roach.
It's kind of like my cat when it glares at me. It's like, I'm going to glare you out of existence. It's like, no, you're not. It's the same principle that cats have when they're glaring you down. They're trying to kill. They want you to die, but you just simply don't.
It's like being in a burning building and going, there is no fire, there is no fire, there is no fire, there is no fire, there is no fire. If I see the fire, then I'm giving it power and it'll burn me. So, nope, there's no fire, there's no fire, there's no fire.
That is one way of, that's another great way of putting it. There's no fire. Then what is that slightly orange gas that is protruding from your shirt, sir? Great question. It burns. Really?
Have you seen my little deviation that's got the hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil, but with skeletons? And it says, if you wouldn't drive your car like this, why would you live your life like this?
Oh, I think, yes, I have seen that one. I have seen that one. Yes. Funny. It's always interesting to do that with, like, some of my friends. 'Cause my friends are just, shall we say, do not have friends like you, Dave. So it's kind of interesting to see when you say these things. Like, I want. Oh, hello, again.
Hello.
Hello. And as far as the image that I was referring to, just so anybody else watching
knows exactly what we're talking about.
Yeah, oh, and let me make sure I clicked a little present to everyone. So, if it is dangerous to drive your car this way, then why would you think it's safe to live your life this way?
I completely agree with that. Holy balls, 11,393 messages. Holy crap. Damn.
A blessing and a curse all at once.
Yes, it's like popularity, but so many messages.
Well, I only have like 300 and some odd followers, getting kind of close to 400, but not quite there yet. And people ask me, wow, you've been on DeviantArt for 10 years, but you only have that many followers? Why is that? I'm like, well, look at the type of stuff I make. And they're like, oh. Yeah, I see your point.
I'm the same way. It's like either people like what I post and what I do and they love me for it, or they just totally hate me and don't want anything to do with me.
What's really funny with me is, like, people, I have 108 watchers now. I just got another one, like, I kid you not, 5 minutes, let's see, how many minutes ago was it now? 10 minutes ago, I now have 108 watchers. Here's the thing: with 108 watchers, guess how many comments I get on, let's say, my writing stuff, which is the stuff I take the most pride in, which is, you know, I write something, I'll sit down, it'll take me like 3 or 4 hours to type out something, and then nothing. It's like, why is it so impossible to get advice? Okay, give me one sec. All right, I will have to go now.
Yes.
Alright, it was nice talking to you.
You as well. It's good that we could at least in a part two, instead of just like all internet goes.
Internet was like died. Yeah,
you don't get an ending. Sorry, watchers, viewers, subscribers.
Sorry.
Fuck you. No, at least we were able to continue it with a part two and close it off properly so that people weren't like, okay, ASDF, and then, huh?
Hmm. Confusing video is confusing.
Yeah. So, we'll talk about this stuff again when you can, you know, next year sometime, but in the meantime, take care, have fun, catch you later. I guess Rich can continue this a little bit more in your absence, and then just kind of bring that to a close.
All right, well, thanks again.
Yep, not a problem. Catch you next time. Alrighty, so anything you were going to say about anything, you know, before you, you know, left to get food and whatever else, and my internet went and all the other shit?
No, everything I was talking about was when it was off air, but he was talking about interesting software programs with, you know, suicide.
We went over that. He went fully into detail about that because I was asking, what's up in the whole, you were mentioning Amazon.
Okay. He went into
the whole thing. He went fully.
Okay, so I don't have to say anything or repeat anything. But I was going to say it's a good idea, except if the only problem is DA itself is full, as we've talked before, with an incompetent staff that wouldn't do anything like that. Because their motive is profit, not actually caring about their users.
Yeah. Well, he was expanding the idea to, like, you know, Amazon and, you know, other sites and services, you know, linking into that sort of thing. And, you know, and then we just kind of moved on from there, and just there was just a gradual shifting of topics and talking about, you know, the educational system and critical thinking or the lack thereof in the educational system, and, you know, the going back to the Prussian indoctrination system and Hitler, and, you know, aka Kristen's father. Oh no, wait, not that Hitler, my bad. Anyway, But yeah, so we were just, you know, you popped in where you popped in, and here we are. So, yeah, pretty much.
Well, today's been, last couple of weeks have been really interesting. Just kind of, you know, slow, but I've been finding things to do. You know, I've been working around here. I've been looking mainly at job stuff lately. It's just kind of, you know, is what it is. Job market sucks right now. Economy's not good, et cetera, so on and so forth.
Well, hey, good opportunity for, you know, getting your YouTube channel together, making, you know, starting to make some money with that. And you also know that sooner rather than later, millionaire's going to hire you back. So it's all good. It's just kind of an opportunity for you to sort things out and take a breather and have some more ease and flow productivity rather than the hammer and nails kind, if you know what I mean. And he bombed out. Okay. I guess everyone's having fun with their internet connection today. Fun with internet. See if he comes back. Come back, Mr. Tate. There you are. Welcome back. Excuse me. I think you're back. You are back, right? Yeah, there you are. Although I hear nothing. I hear nothing. I hear zero. For reasons unknown, I hear nothing. Absolutely nothing is what I hear. And now he's gone.
Oh, now I can hear you.
There you are. Welcome back.
Yeah, my browser crashed again.
Well, all I was saying is that this is just an opportunity for you to, you know, have some ease and flow with your productivity and, you know, relax into some YouTube stuff and make some money that way. And inevitably, Millionaire will be hiring you back. I'm sure they already pretty much said as much. So, you know, it's just an opportunity to show yourself that you can be productive on an ease and flow rather than a, you know, boot up the head, sort of, you know.
Yeah. Hell, I might as well do that. I've been productive with a lot of other stuff. I might as well look in my YouTube and...
Yeah, you got that badass internet connection now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's no reason why I shouldn't.
Exactly.
Really. But for meantime, you know, I just want to find something at some point. It was interesting. My mother called me earlier on the phone.
Uh-huh.
And apparently one of her coworkers' husbands or whatever needed help with a roof or something. But they said that he could call me back, and he hasn't called me back yet at all. So I don't know.
I don't know. Maybe it's not urgent. Maybe it's just something to where they're replacing something or doing general construction, and it's something that might take a week to complete. So it's not like it's, oh shit, drop everything and help now, or the roof is going to catch fire, or, you know, whatever.
Because
I know a lot of those construction jobs can be days and days and days, sometimes longer.
I think it's just somebody working on their house. I don't think it's construction.
Well, by construction, I just mean the type of job.
Oh, it's just, I guess the guy's working on shingles on his roof or whatever, and he needs somebody to help, you know, peel the shingles off and stuff.
Exactly. In Chicago, that's a part of the classification of construction work. Roofing, new front porch, new sidewalks, drywall. So that's construction.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so should wrap this up as far as the broadcast is concerned, or is there anything else you wanted to add?
Not really. I'm just, you know, pretty much describing what I've been doing lately, and that's pretty much that. I don't really have anything else to say.
Yep. Me neither, not on, you know, the topics and stuff that, you know, we've been discussing here. So I guess we can end it here. Thanks, everybody, for watching. And, you know, sorry about the glitches and, you know, this needing a part two and all that crazy stuff. But, you know, it happens. Internet can be a very strange thing sometimes. Very strange indeed. So, you know, believe nothing, disbelieve nothing, question everything, and catch y'all later.